I better get G-Force on this right away.
Come in, G-Force. Hot scan. Center Neptune calling. This is 7, Zark 7. Come in, Mark.
Okay, ears on. 10-2, Zark.
Assemble your team, Commander. I've located an invader from Spectra on my scanner.
Proceed to point 13X, grid 40. I will now transmute you to full jet.
Big test. Okay, transmute.
Well, that's just one of the many conversion phases I control, but Mark's the real leader of G-Force. And Princess is the only female member of the team. This big fellow is Tiny Harper. He pilots the command ship and assembles the crew. Sort of pay special attention to Princess. I really don't know just why. This is Keon. He's very special and different. He was manufactured, grown from a single embryonic cell in the laboratory. His speech is a little peculiar, but his powers are amazing. And finally, this is Jason. Very capable, but just a trifle eager and hot-headed sometimes. So emotional. I do wish he had solid-state circuitry like mine. These G-Force members all have miniaturized cerebonic implants, which give them fantastic abilities beyond those of other humans. Orphans who have been trained almost since birth to develop those secret and mysterious powers. Even though they're so capable, I wish I could be with them on dangerous missions because I do worry. But I'm just an old stay-at-home stationary think tank.